My name is Mary AwaaWaa2, and I'm the center coordinator for AwaaWaa2. AwaaWaa2 is a center that supports children with speech and language difficulties. We are located in Accra, and I am a parent of a child with autism. This center has been in existence for the past 11 years, and it was started by a speech and language therapist. I draw up the program for the children. I counsel the parents, you know, to understand what it is that, you know, they are dealing with in terms of supporting their children. I do a lot of advocacy, you know, training, and I advocate on TV, radio, on talk shows, just to let people understand about inclusion. That is including our children who have disabilities in the mainstream.
Brushing.
I draw closer to parents who have children like myself, so that we form a bond, like a parent self-help group, where we share ideas, we encourage each other, because it's a difficult and a tough journey, and you need a shoulder to cry on once a while. No one would want the autism diagnosis, you know. Everybody looks up to a child who would grow up, you know, become what they expect them to be. But here you are with a child who may need support for the rest of their lives. If you are lucky, they may be very functional and may be able to do things for themselves. But, you know, talking from a parent's perspective, there's so much social stigma. People don't understand. Once they can't see the disability, they want to believe that it is not there. It makes it very difficult. And because they don't understand, seeking for services also becomes a problem. Because you only start seeking for services when you understand and accept that there's a challenge. But people run to us maybe when the child is 6 or 7 or 8, when they know that, okay, it's gotten to a point where I really need to get help, you understand. By that time, they might have missed on a lot of the early intervention services that they could have gotten earlier.
Hey!
James and Ekai. This is the kick on.